All right. Welcome back, everybody. We are on the Gifts of Caucasus map. Still working away. We're on field 13, the B side, harvesting some carrots here. We have some corn over here on this half of field 13. Got quite a bit of work done since the last video. Don't remember exactly where we left off, but been busy. We have 691,000 in the bank, and in the bank account, and we don't owe the bank anything at the moment. So yeah, well, the map gave us a little bonus. It offered up field number 6 for $220,000, so we hopped on that. The owner was ready to let go of that at a knockdown price, so yeah, we jumped on that. Other than that, we still have field 5 and field 13 or 18. Field 5 has some barley on it we need to harvest. Field 6 is planted with wheat, but I don't think it's ready yet. And we just finished harvesting sugar beets off of field 18, so it is ready to go also. But first thing we're going to do is we're going to chaff this corn over here and get some of that in the BGA. So we're going to go here to the shop. And we're going to get the Fortschritt, maybe is how you say it. Harvester. It is only $60,000. It's a lot cheaper than the in-game crone, so we're gonna grab it, and we're gonna go back, and we're gonna get a. Let's see. Oh, wrong one. Okay, and we're gonna go to headers. The header is only 4.5 meters. I think the crone is like 12 or 11. But that would be nice, but you know, that's a $500,000 setup and we're being cheap. You know, we need all the money we can get. So speaking of all that we can get, our rating, we are finally up to a 40. But if you notice there, we have a railroad penalty that costs us 5. I was at 39, and apparently a course play driver ran a red signal at a railroad and cost us about, I don't remember how much money it was, a couple thousand dollars, and worse than that, cost us 5 rating points. So So that knocked us back down a little bit. We're back up to 40, so we could buy field 9 if we wanted to, or put another bid in it. Say we can't just buy anything, but let's see, we're gonna, oh wow, we jumped there and won. I did use this guy, let's see, on the we used him on the Idaho map. And I don't think we had any problems with him. It's not the best model, I guess, but you know, he's cheap and he works, so we can afford to do the crone. No, too bad. He's all right. But until we could afford to upgrade to that, he'll do just fine and save us some money. I do. Fast as he's gonna go. I do kinda have a new plan. But if you've been watching the series, you know plans don't always work out like they're supposed to. But if we bring up the map here while we drive, I think I can do both. I was thinking that if we want to buy the brewery, or the beer factory as it's called on this map, we're going to need a lot of money. I don't remember what that costs. I haven't even looked, but, you know, 3 or 4 million maybe. Any of those production facilities are $3 to $5 million. So, you know, we need a lot of money. And at this point still, our main source of income is the BGA. I have been working on filling up the fruits, but that just takes a while to build everything up. So I thought we would put a bid in. Oh, I passed where I was going. On field 17. And what we would do with it is we would plant it up with corn, and we could chaff it and put it in the BGA, which is just right there. That would be awesome. We could, you know, constantly have keeping the BGA filled up and keeping it rocking, and then we'll be able to buy fields. And I know we're only at a rating 40. We got to be at least 50 to buy the beer factory, but I figured we could start working on saving some money while we're doing that. So have been trying to do all of the quick cargo deliveries that come up. I think we've done 16 of them. And I would like to do more of the contracts, but you know, I keep changing like what I thought we would need to have in storage. Like, you know, first time the contracts were coming up at 60 or 80,000 liters of whatever, and we wouldn't have that. And then, you know, I got things to be at 100,000 in storage on some of them, and then they would come up at 140 or 150. And, you know, the last one came up at almost 200,000. So I've almost decided in my head that to do any of the I still haven't been able to even do a contract. But to do any of the contracts, I'm really just going to need to keep about 500,000 of each fruit on hand. And then I figure I should be safe. But we'll see how that goes. Let's see if we can get a course set up here real quick. Oh, maybe go back to here. We are on, let's see, we got to put in 13A. Outline. Let me go to here. Currently loaded course. What is that? This one says 5.5. Is that right? I thought it said that the header was only 4.5. What does this say? 4.5. Okay. We are going to back that down to, yeah, 4.5, starting corner, south, east, starting direction, north, bring it back, we'll do 2, two headlands ought to be good. Okay, calculate. Save it. Field 13A. Chaff. We'll call it chop 4.5 meters. Alright. We'll save that. And him ready to go. And then before we send him off, we're going to need to do a to record a an unload course. So, but yeah, I thought if we could just keep rocking on the BGA and really bank some cash while we continue to put fruits in storage, then you know, when it comes time to be able to buy the beer factory, when we have a high enough rating, then you know we'll have money and not have to try and wait for that time period. I think, you know, like I have, I can't check right now because I'm driving, but or recording the course. I know we have 700,000 or 800,000 potatoes and say sugar beets in storage already. So you know those are two in particular that I know that I'm comfortable selling those down to at least you know 500,000, if not a little, if not less than that. So that's something we'll be looking at doing here pretty shortly too. But that field 17 would be just right here by the BGA. That would be just such a short run. That's definitely in the plan, and I was even thinking I might even, our problem's going to be with the unloading guy even being able to keep up. So I was thinking about even planting up 18 with corn for the time being, because I was planning on using that for like sugar beets and potatoes, but I haven't had time to sell those off, and the field's ready to be planted, so we could just go ahead and throw another field of corn together and you know have that one ready to go too, and just go ahead and chaff it up. And this guy's driving kind of slow while he's unloading, but we'll be out of our way in a second. He'll take off now. And then we'll go out this side over here. So we'll keep our traffic flow going. I might pull that guy off of the mower and get, I don't really want to buy any more equipment than necessary, but we might pull him off the grass mowing while we chap this field, just to keep it going, because I decided when I bought this loading wagon, the other thing I've been doing to make money is we've been doing our grains up on that top field up there, what is it, field 5, and the straw sell point is actually just right up there on top of a hill. So I have been using this rig right here to follow behind the harvester, pick up all the straw, and go ahead and sell it. And we get, I don't remember what it is off that field, but it's well over 100,000 from selling straw off that field. So that's pretty good too. So that's why I have this second loading wagon, but when I was buying this one, I noticed that you can also put chaff in here. And both of them, as a matter of fact. So I'm hoping that when we get this going, we can also use these for carting off the chaff. And then it's dual purpose as a loading wagon and as a for dealing with the chaff. So we'll save that. Unload BGA. Okay, and we'll save that. All right. And yep, that's the guy we want. So we'll put him on that. And let's see if we jump over to this guy, if we can get this rig, get this combo going. And it seems like there was something first when we, when I was, come on mouse, when I was doing this on Idaho. That was a bit glitchy. We better do one of these real quick. That seemed weird. Couldn't remember. Just seemed like there was... That's why he didn't take off. I didn't tell him to drive. So let's see if I can't get... something, and I don't remember what I had to do to get things going right when I had the oh, there he goes. Going. Well, we might have to play around with this guy off camera to get it straightened out. Or should we have bought the crone? Oh, let's see what these guys are doing. Remember on Idaho what the deal was with oh, I got chaff in here. That's no good. That's no good. Was that part of the problem? Too many many deals right there? Too many wagons? Look at that. It was. He was all confused. Who was catching? I'll be darn. Really, buddy? Now where are you going? I'm just gonna play ring around the tree. Ring around the Rosie. Alright, what do you think? Okay, looks like he's going. So, okay. Well, the bad thing is we got chaff in here. Well, poop. We will just leave this guy. We're just going to get him over here out of the way, off the field for the moment. I wonder, let's see, how much is in? Well, he's got a ways to go. What else we can do is we can jump up here. We can get this guy started. We'll go ahead and get this guy harvesting on field 5. Jump over to our truck here and we'll get him set up. I have been having this guy running slurry as often as the garden center will take it. So really been trying to sell as much as we can. The milk, we always seem to have a surplus of milk. The map just doesn't buy enough of it, which is kind of a drag because, you know, we don't even have 100 cows yet and we make more milk than the map can buy. Anyhow, let's see, we get this guy set up on field 5. Unload. I need to set up a new unload course, but we'll go ahead and use this one again for now. No, that's not the one we want. Where's the case? There he is. So we'll get him unloading on that. We can run down here and see if can run this down to the BGA real quick. So we can get him back on carrots. You know what I want? You know what we should do though? Let's see, what is field 17 is normally 580. And we got 621. I bet we're not going to get it for that. I was hoping to be able to put a bid in on this episode on field 17, but I don't think that's going to happen. That we're going to have enough time to do that, but we could. Maybe we'll get we can get this guy unloaded real quick. Since we can't get that field yet, we probably need to have about 800,000 in the bank before we go put a bid in, because we know we're not going to get it for that price. So we should probably just go ahead and plant up a field. Oh, we can get to it right there too. Oh, that's nice. We could set up a, we could just set our path up for both fields. That would be the thing to do. And then if we wanted to set up to double chaff or whether we're doing our vegetables, we can get everything coming in and out of that access right there. Yeah, that's the ticket. So we should have about 800,000 before we go put our bid in. Do I even got this guy down here unloading? Oh, he's not. Well, that's the problem. We need to, let's get him going on. I can't believe I didn't have him going. We'll just go ahead and we'll just get him unloading number one. We're sitting on all kinds of money there. Not sure why I had him off to the side. Wasn't thinking, I guess. Yeah, we should be rocking. I finally feel like I'm making good progress on the map. But we're probably 90 hours in on the map, and it still feels like we're just getting started. We haven't even started really hardly messing with any of the production stuff. Mess around a little bit when I'm not busy doing stuff. Rest of the stuff on the map with the cement factory, but I really want to get something going that we own everything. And that's why we got barley and wheat planted up in those top fields. I want to be all ready to go with lots of barley and lots of barley. We don't necessarily need wheat for the brewery, but we need the barley and hops. So I want to have tons of that going when we can do that. But yeah, I finally feel like, you know, we're starting to make headway. We got a couple more fields now, so we can, you know, get the crop rotation going a little faster. Why don't you want to go? Field 13, right? I need to get you closer. I need to go pull the mower guy off and get him over here. We need both of these on this cornfield probably. There he goes. Let's see what that guy is up to if he's... Oh good, he's getting ready to unload, and we can just pull him off of there. Ride along with him for a minute. Actually, we're just going to stop him right here. We're going to leave the mower right here. I know I'm going to wish I hadn't left it there and left it over by the field, but we'll know where it's at. We're going to go ahead and take over this guy. Oh, that's wrong button. Oh no. You get it? Oh, we got us. Oh, come on. Can't reset anything on this map. It costs us money. Dang. Oh no. Now I'm really making a mess. How about that? We get the front end loader over here, if we can turn him back over. Let's jump up and see what these guys got going on here. Maybe, hopefully, it ain't too heavy and we can get him turned back over. Otherwise, I don't know what it costs for us to reset it. Haven't had to do that yet, but I wonder if I go up high and push. There we go. I wasn't too bad. But I wonder yet. Oh. I wonder if I can get in there to... if that's close enough to hook up yet. Oh. There, now, finally. All right. I wonder, let's see, if we can't get this one out, and if we can't load up, let's see, what is it, field 13, unload BGA, oh, we need to put him on this, and we need to put him on the force rit, that guy. And see if he won't pick up the he's gonna pick up the course. Alright, we can jump back over. See if we can't get this guy back to work. Him back to work. I think it's been 30 minutes already, but we're going to go a little longer. And we're going to jump over to, let's see, we need, not that guy, this guy. And we need to get him down to field 18. Get him set up and going, and we'll go ahead and get the seeder let's get the seeder started down there, then I'll call it an episode. So hopefully, by the time I get an opportunity to record again, which I haven't had much, my work schedule has still been pretty busy. This is the only day I've had off this week. So I have just had the course play workers pretty much working all day while I was doing chores, mowing the lawn, doing some laundry, doing all kinds of stuff. So hopefully, as the schedule allows, don't be surprised if the next episode I already have Field 17. I would like to wait to do it while I was recording, but we'll see. Might be able to squeak in a little bit of time to do some recording this week. I don't know. We'll just have to see how the schedule goes. But if not, I think we got a plan. But we'll see. We'll see how the map. We'll see what the map thinks about our plan, because the map doesn't like plans. So let's see, field 18, right, spray, refill, boom, first waypoint, go. And then if we jump over to this guy, yeah. So I guess this is a new seeder, I think, since the last video. It's okay. It does do all the fruits. So it does do the carrots, so we no longer have to do any 3-meter seeding, which is really nice, but it's not a perfect mod. It is big, and it was expensive. It was $200,000, which I guess that's not terrible for a big, nice seeder, but we'll see when we hit the pavement over here. I don't know what it is. It's like there's a collision box or something that hangs down too low to the road, and it like clicks on the edges of the pavement pieces or something. But it's a little goofy, but we can work with it. Like I said, at least it's fine when we're not driving on the pavement, so it's weird. And the other thing that's weird is the dust that it kicks up while you're driving. When you have it folded, the dust pattern is if it's unfolded in a field. So that's kind of weird, but it was the only, when I did a Google search for multi-fruit seeders, this one just kept popping up everywhere, so it's the one we went with. I didn't have a lot of time to be looking around, but I knew that I was done with doing 3-meter seeding. We're still stuck with doing some 3-meter harvesting, and that's okay, but to do 3-meter seeding, we just weren't getting nowhere, and there's just too much work to do on this map. So this guy's working till we find something better. Probably need to go and sell off the, I don't really need the cultivator anymore. I take that back. If we see, this will seed potatoes, but I feel like that's a little cheaty because it's not a potato seeder. So we still do use the potato seeder you see over there sitting by the shed. So we do need to keep the cultivator, but I could sell off that other seeder. We won't be using it. So let's see if we can get some corn here. Don't know how much it'll take. We'll take plenty of seeds with us, so I don't have to do a refill run. So yeah, maybe by the next episode we'll have that other field. Or if not, if I don't buy it till I have a chance to record, then maybe we'll chaff up a bunch of corn and we'll just have a ton of money in the bank. That would be kind of fun too. So I think we'll stop at about 10,000. Surely it won't take any more than that. I hope. All right, we'll run this down there. And thanks to the, you know, I want to say thanks to the new subscribers and our current subscribers, our old subscribers. There are certainly people that have been with us for quite a while. But we do have a few new ones popping up since we've started working on this map, so that's awesome. Yeah, hope you guys are enjoying the series, and if you're, you know, playing this map and there's been things that you've figured out that I haven't figured out, certainly this is a very, deep map, maybe is a good word. There's lots of stuff to find on this map. I still have only found a handful of coins, maybe 6 or 7. So yeah, I'm just kind of taking it as it comes and learning things as we go. Like I said, I still don't know much about the production facilities. I have been watching some videos or our series, but so I know a little bit. But as far as it seems like when you do things yourself and you start to learn things hands-on, is a better way for me to remember stuff. So, but yeah, it's a very, very detailed, very thorough, very deep map. There's lots to do and lots to learn. So, wonder if I should wait a little bit, or we'll just go ahead and get this guy going. And if they run into each other, I'll sort it out. But let's see. There. I should have one for this guy. And, there he is. Get him going. What I do like about this cedar is he doesn't miss much. He doesn't leave any unplanted, are very, very few, very small, unplanted areas. So that's awesome. That's why I really like that about this thing. Makes up for its little glitches. All right, let's see what this guy's got going on. Okay, so I need to get out of here. Into this one. See if we can figure out where this guy's going. Oh, he's starting to do his up and downs. Is that close enough? Come on. No? Dang. See if we can pull in right behind him here then. So yeah, he's going to be busy working on this field for a while, so. Man, we're going to have a ton of stuff in the VGA, though. That's going to be awesome. All right, well, yeah, I think we're at about 45 minutes or so. That's plenty long, so, yeah, thanks for watching, and if you're liking the series, please hit the like button. Helps the channel out a lot, or better yet, subscribe, and you'll be notified when we post some new videos. And I'm your host, Zigzaggy, and we will see you on the farm next time.